is minus tan inverse of omega. This is the magnitude and this is the phase angle of this system, which is nothing but representing the sinusoidal response only. So f of j omega is having a magnitude of 1 by root of 1 plus omega square, and phase angle is tan inverse omega. Given x of t is equal to sin t, compare this with sin omega t, omega value is 1. So magnitude of the response will become 1 by root 2 and angle will lag by 45. Now if you observe, subjecting a system to a sin omega t plus or minus phi 1, अब यहाँ पे a वैल्यू क्या है 1, a वैल्यू क्या है 1, phi 1 क्या है 0, what is phi 1 वैल्यू 0, what is the magnitude of the response, output क्या है b sin omega t plus or minus phi 2 है, what is the b value, a into magnitude of the system, this is the magnitude of the system 1 by root 2, what is a value 1. So output y of t will have a magnitude of 1 by root 2, sin omega value is 1, sin omega value is 1. What is this phase angle of the output phi 2 plus or minus phi 1 plus angle of the system? What is phi 1 in the given input? 0. 0 plus what is the angle you have got for the system at s equal to j omega? So t minus 45. This is the answer. You understand? Suppose agar yahan pe 10 sin t hai, yahan pe kya hai 10 sin t hai, put s equal to j omega, you will find what is the magnitude of the system, 10 by root a into magnitude of the input signal, magnitude of the system. You understand? Agar yahan pe 10 sin t plus 20 hai, 10 sin t plus 20 kya hai yahan pe, 10 by root 2 minus 45 plus 20 kitna ho gaya, t minus 25. Samajh mein aaya? सेकेंड क्वेश्चन देखो क्या है, ट्रांसफर फंक्शन बोलो, जी ऑफ एस इज इक्वल टू एस स्क्वायर प्लस 9 इंटू एस प्लस 2 बाई एस प्लस 3 एस प्लस 4 एंड एस प्लस 5. द क्वेश्चन इज स्टेडी स्टेट साइनसॉइडल रेस्पॉन्स विल बिकम जीरो एट व्हाट फ्रीक्वेंसी, स्टेडी स्टेट साइनसॉइडल रेस्पॉन्स विल बिकम जीरो एट व्हाट फ्रीक्वेंसी. Steady state sinusoidal response means you have to subject the system to sin omega t. Subjecting a system to sin omega t input is simply putting s equal to j omega. Agar s equal to j omega, if you put in a transfer function, it is an indication that the system is subjected to sinusoidal input. So when you put s equal to j omega, so when you put s equal to j omega, this will become, okay, s plus 2 either. So when you put s equal to j omega, this becomes the sinusoidal transfer function of the system. Omega square plus 9, j omega plus 2, j omega plus 3, j omega plus 4, j omega plus 5. This sinusoidal response is becoming 0. Minus omega square plus 9 is 0. Omega value will become 3. So this sinusoidal response will become 0 at a frequency of 3. You understand? Now in this example, say, second part I am writing here, though it is not asked, find y of t for x of t is equal to 10 sine t minus 25. So x of t is equal to 10 sine t minus 25 means, what is the y of t expression now? Y of t will become 10 by root 2 sine of t minus 25 and minus 45. Kitna? Minus 60, 70. This will be the answer for this input, 10 sine t minus 25, according to this expression. Understood? Frequency response plots. The main use of plotting these frequency response plots, that is magnitude and phase angle versus frequency, is to comment on the stability of the system. This is the main use and application of frequency response methods. Already we have learned some methods to find the stability of a system.
अरे वहां से वैसे डाउनलोड नहीं होता है,
कई बार रिफ्रेश कर दी समझ में ना क्या
आ जाता है, अपने आप वो ले लेता है। पहले तुमको टॉरेंट फाइल डाउनलोड करना पड़ेगा, तो टॉरेंट फाइल के लिए तुमको ढूंढना पड़ेगा किस में है टॉरेंट फाइल जो तुम उसमें डाउनलोड कर सकते हैं।
Magnitude and phase angle versus frequency, we get plots called as frequency response plots. And the main use of drawing these frequency response plots is to comment on the stability of the system. Now, already we have learned some methods to find stability, like Rao-Savitz criteria and root locus plots. Now these are some more methods in frequency domain to comment on the stability of a system. The first and the foremost plots are called as polar plots. In polar plots, we take whatever absolute values of magnitude you get and phase angle in degrees. Plot it directly versus omega. Such plots are called as polar plots. Now instead of taking the absolute values, if you take decibel values of magnitude, decibel values of magnitude, a decibel value is defined as, a dB value is defined as 20 log of the absolute value. The decibel value is defined as 20 log of the absolute value. And phase angle in degrees. And plot it versus log omega. Then such plots are called as Bode plots. Plotting versus log omega doesn't mean that you are taking log values of omega. Iska matlab ye nahi hai. Log omega ka matlab hai, x-axis is a log scale. Instead of calibrating omega on a linear scale, you are calibrating omega on a logarithmic scale. So you have to read omega values as you read on a linear scale, on a log scale also. So omega calibrated on a log scale, we show it as log omega. Decibel value, 20 log of absolute values when you take, the advantage is, when you write a decibel value magnitude, the decibel value magnitude we can compare with an equation for straight line, y equal to mx or mx plus c. Which means, by taking the decibel values of magnitudes, the magnitude characteristics we show or draw in the form of straight lines. It is asymptotic in nature. That is the advantage of defining the decibel values of magnitudes. You can draw the magnitude characteristics as straight lines, because any decibel value magnitude we can compare with an equation for straight line, y equal to mx or mx plus c. Now, with the main aim of drawing these plots, Polar, Nyquist and Bode, the main aim of drawing these plots is to comment on stability of the system. Now, before we talk about these plots, first we will do frequency response analysis of a second order system. We have done time response of a second order system and we have defined certain time domain specifications. We will now do frequency response analysis of a second order system and define frequency domain specifications. And after that we will go to these plots. First Polar, Nyquist and then Bode.
तो ये जीरो के इक्वल होगा या ये जीरो के इक्वल होगा, ये है ना दो, ये तो जीरो हो गया, इवन तक मल्टीप्लाई हो गया खत्म। तो इन दोनों में से या तो ये जीरो होगा या ये जीरो होगा, कोई एक जीरो होगा तो ये जीरो होगा, ठीक है। तो एक बार हम इसको जीरो के इक्वल करके करते हैं तो ओमेगा 3 एडिट कर, तो इसको एक बार जीरो के इक्वल करेंगे तो क्या आएगा, -2 बाई जे आएगा, कम्प्लेक्स आ जाएगा। कम्प्लेक्स में फ्रिक्वेंसी बताया गया नहीं,
subheading frequency response analysis of second order system. Frequency response analysis of second order system. Thank you. frequency response analysis of second order system. Now listen here. The transfer function of a second order system is f of s is equal to c of s by r of s is omega n square by 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square. Whenever we do frequency response analysis, it is always better to convert the transfer function in time constant form. Transfer functions represented in time constant form, the angles we can take, taking angles will become easy. That is the advantage of that form. That is why we show transfer functions in time constant form, because these forms we more use in frequency response methods. What is the time constant form of this transfer function? You have to take out omega n square common 2 zeta s by omega n plus 1. Subjecting a system to sin omega t input is simply putting s equal to j omega. So when you put s equal to j omega, it indicates that the second order system is subjected to sin omega t input. So the sinusoidal transfer function of a second order system is j omega square by omega n square 2 zeta j omega by omega n plus 1. So the sinusoidal transfer function will become 1 by j square value is minus 1. So 1 by omega n whole square is 1 minus omega by omega n whole square plus this is j into 2 zeta omega by omega n. Magnitude of the second order system will become 1 by root of 1 minus omega by omega n whole square 2 zeta omega by omega n whole square. This is the magnitude. When you plot this magnitude versus frequency, you get magnitude characteristics of the second order system. So you see, when omega value is 0, what is the magnitude? When omega value is 0, what is the magnitude? 1. As you put different values of omega in that magnitude, these are the magnitude characteristics you get for a second order system. Now from these magnitude characteristics, we define the specifications as the maximum value of magnitude called as MR will occur at a frequency called as omega R. The frequency at which the magnitude has a value of 1 by root 2, that frequency is called as cutoff frequency. The frequency, the range of frequencies over which the magnitude has a value of 1 by root 2 is called as bandwidth. Now these are called as frequency domain specifications. If you observe, we have taken absolute values of magnitude and we have plotted versus omega. These are the typical characteristics that we have got. Now these characteristics, we can convert them into straight lines by taking decibel values and plotting versus log omega. So as I said, log omega doesn't mean we are taking any log values of omega. Log omega ka matlab ye nahi hai. Log omega ka matlab hai, instead of calibrating omega on a linear scale, we are calibrating omega on log scale. Like how you read omega values on a linear scale, in the same way you have to read omega values on log scale. Because this is a log scale, 0 is not defined on a log scale. So you must always start from smallest frequency values. Suppose I start from 0.1. The next frequency value will be 10 times of that. So 0.1 into 10, next frequency is how much? Next frequency? 100, 1000, 10,000, 1 lakh, like that. If you observe, on a log scale, you are able to mark 0.1, 0.01, and you are also able to mark 10 cube or 10 power 4 also. Is it possible on a linear scale? Which means by calibrating omega on a log scale, very low frequencies, what will be the response you are observing? Very high frequencies, 10 cube, 10 power 4 also, you are observing what will be the response. That means most of the values of omega you can accommodate when you take a logarithmic scale. Decibel value magnitudes, when you define decibel value magnitudes, the advantage is the magnitude characteristics can be drawn in the form of a straight line, because any decibel value magnitude you can compare with an equation for straight line mx or mx plus c. Now this is the absolute value. What will be the decibel value of this magnitude? Decibel value of this magnitude will be, its dB value is 20 log of the absolute value. What is this? Root of this whole thing to the power minus 1. 20 log of root of this whole thing to the power minus 1 will become how much? Minus 20 log of root of this whole expression. So its decibel value will become minus 20 log of root of 1 minus omega by omega n whole square 2 zeta omega by omega n whole square. This is the decibel value magnitude of this second order system. As I said, any decibel value magnitude you can compare with an equation for straight line y equal to mx or mx plus c form. If I want to compare this decibel value magnitude with y equal to mx, m is the slope. What is m? Slope. Ye jo x hai, x should always be of the form of log omega only. Koi bhi decibel value magnitude agar mx ya mx plus c form se compare karna hai, m is the slope. What is m? Slope. This x should always be of the form of log omega only. Then only the decibel value magnitude represents a straight line. Why x should always be of the form of log omega only? Because ye x axis kya hai? Isliye. Suppose if I want to compare this decibel value magnitude with mx, m slope to minus 20 hai. But x is not log omega, as you see. X kya hai? Log of, root of, ye sab expression hai. So this equation taken as it is does not represent a straight line. Taken as it is. Since it is not representing a straight line, you have to approximate it to represent a straight line. And hence we make asymptotic approximations. Straight line approximations. We are approximating this expression to represent a straight line. Because we are doing asymptotic or straight line approximations, wherever zeta term is present, I am considering its effect to be negligible. Why? As we proceed, I will tell you. So this expression, I am writing it as minus 20 log of root of 1 minus omega by omega n square whole square. Ye bhi term idhar hai, but compared to this term, I am considering its effect to be negligible. In this expression, the only available variable is omega. So case 1, I take very very low frequency values. In the low frequency, this 1 is very much greater than this term. This will reduce to minus 20 log of root 1 will become. So this magnitude in very low frequencies is 0. Case 2, we take now some high frequency values. In the high frequencies, omega by omega n square will be very much greater than 1. This expression reduces to minus 20 log of root of minus of omega by omega n square whole square. negative sign inside a square makes no sense. Square and root will get cancelled. This reduces to minus 20 log omega by omega n whole square, which is nothing but minus 40 log omega by omega n. I am calling this as equation 1. Now this minus 40 log omega by omega n, we can write it as minus 40 log omega plus 40 log omega n. And if you observe this expression, we can compare it with y equal to m x plus c. So if you see x kya hai, iska matlab equation 1 represents a straight line having what slope? Slope m is minus 40. Ye slope ke units hai db per decade. db kyunki ye db value hai, decade because ye jo logarithmic scale hai ye distance between two frequencies 10 times hai. Ye distance is called as one decade distance. So the unit of the slope, we write it as db per decade. This magnitude we are now drawing as two parts. In the low frequencies, this magnitude is having a value of 0. In the high frequencies, this magnitude is drawn as a straight line having a slope of minus 40 dB per decade. Because this magnitude we are drawing in two parts, we have to know up to what value of omega it is considered as low and from what value of omega it is considered as high frequencies. So the frequency which demarcates the low and high frequency regions, kya frequency tak low hai, then high, that frequency value you have to know. So this frequency which demarcates the low and high frequency regions is called as corner frequency. Now to find this corner frequency, the procedure is equate the low frequency magnitude and high frequency magnitude. So log omega by omega n is also 0. Omega by omega n is log inverse of 0, 1. The corner frequency of this system is omega n. So up to corner frequency, the magnitude will be 0. And from this corner frequency, the magnitude is drawn as a straight line having a slope of minus 40 dB per decade. I am taking a separate 0 dB line just to show the characteristics properly. So up to corner frequency value can come anywhere. So I am assuming this corner frequency somewhere here. So up to this corner frequency omega n, the magnitude will be 0. From this corner frequency, the magnitude is drawn as a straight line having a slope of minus 40 dB per decade. Negative slope downwards, positive slope upwards. How to exactly draw, we will see later. But as of now, I am showing the straight line of slope minus 40 this way. This is indicating a slope of minus 40 dB per decade. This region is called as low frequency region and this region is called as high frequency region. So these magnitude characteristics, if you observe, we have converted into straight lines by taking what? Decibel values versus log omega. In this now this blue line is nothing but this equation. This entire equation is the blue line now. So in the blue line, at corner frequency, what is the magnitude you are observing? 0. Which means, if you put the corner frequency value in this expression, this entire expression should become 0. So let us see. At omega equal to omega CF equal to omega N. This is minus 20 log of root of 1 minus 1 square plus 2 zeta square is minus 20 log of 2 zeta. So you see, as you see in the plot, at corner frequency the magnitude is not zero. There is some error, and that error is depending on the value of zeta, which means this plot will actually look like this. There will be some error like this. This much error with this magnitude at corner frequency will be there. This is the slope of minus 40 and this is 0 dB line. So as a, actually as a rahega plot yahan pe corner frequency ke paas some error will be there. Kya ye straight line hai? Huh? When you say you are making straight line approximations, when you say the effect of this term is negligible, you are actually implying this error is negligible. Because error is depending on what? That is why you neglect that term and you represent as straight lines. Samajh mein aaya? We have also done time response of the second order system. We have subjected the second order system to unit step input like this. And this was the nature of response we got. This was the nature of response we got. This part of time response we called it as transient state. This part of time response we got it as, we called it as transient state. This part of time response we called it as steady state. Now I am asking you a question. In which part, transient state or steady state? The output is quantitatively available for different units of time. In which part, whether in the transient state or steady state? The output is quantitatively available for different units of time. Transient state. In steady state, the output has reached the constant final value. There is no quantitative output values for different units of time. I mean, there is no output here. I am asking in frequency domain analysis, in which part, whether it is the low frequencies or high frequency region, the output or magnitude is quantitatively available for different values of omega. Therefore, the high frequency region of frequency response is correlated with transient state in time domain. The low frequency region is correlated with steady state. This is the correlation between the transient state, steady state of time response, the high frequency and low frequency regions of frequency response. A P plus D controller or a phase lead compensator is used for improving transient state, which means it will deal with that is why it acts as a high pass filter. A P plus I controller or a phase lag compensator is used for improving steady state, which means it will always deal with low frequency signals. That is why we say it acts as a low pass filter. Why PID is a band reject filter, in Bode plots I will show. Second order system. frequency domain specifications. First one, resonant frequency omega r. It is defined as the frequency at which the magnitude has maximum value. So, what is the magnitude of second order system? 1 by root of 1 minus u square whole square 2 zeta u whole square, where what is this u? Omega by omega n. And omega equal to omega r equal to resonant frequency. U is equal to u r, which is omega r by omega n. So when omega is omega r, this magnitude is having a maximum value. So to obtain an expression for u r, differentiate this magnitude and equate it to 0. 2 zeta u r whole square to the power of minus half, equate this to 0. This is minus half u r square whole square 2 zeta u r whole square to the power of minus 3 by 2 into d by d u r of 2 zeta u r whole square, equate this to 0. Now this entire expression is 0, only this will remain. So this will become 2 into 1 minus u r square minus 2 u r, 4 zeta square into 2 u r equal to 0. 2 u r square minus 2 u r, 8 zeta square u r equal to 0, plus 4 u r cube, 8 zeta square u r equal to 0. Take out 4 u r common, minus 1, 2 zeta square, 1 minus 2 zeta square, 2 zeta square. Omega n into root of 1 minus 2 zeta square. This is the expression to calculate the value of resonant frequency. Frequency cannot be negative. So, for omega r to be real and positive, 2 zeta square should be less than 1. Means zeta should be less than 1 by root 2. This resonant frequency, it is correlated with omega d, which is omega n into root of 1 minus zeta square. For omega d to be real and positive, zeta square should be less than 1, which means zeta should be. So time response mein, like how all specifications exist for zeta less than 1, vaisa frequency response में all specifications will exist for zeta less than 1 by root. ये correlation है time response में और frequency response. Time response में जैसा rise time peak time specifications है, frequency response में ये specifications.
दुर्गा पूजा कब से स्टार्ट है? 23 से. एक भी दिन छुट्टी देगा कि नहीं मेडी जी? कौन गाना बजा रहे हैं?
It is the maximum value of magnitude. It is the maximum value of magnitude occurring at resonant frequency omega. The maximum value of magnitude occurring at resonant frequency omega. So magnitude of the second order system at resonant frequency is MR. So MR is given by the expression 1 by root of omega n into root of 1 minus 2 zeta square by omega n whole square omega n into root of by omega n whole square. You are substituting this resonant frequency value in the magnitude. So this expression gets reduced to 1 by 2 zeta into root of 1 minus zeta square. This is the expression to calculate the resonant frequency. So you see, resonant frequency is the maximum value of magnitude occurring at resonant frequency. This is MR occurring at omega. What is the maximum value in time domain? Maximum value in time domain, since this portion is MP. This is not maximum value. This is only maximum peak overshoot value. The maximum value in time domain is nothing but 1 plus MP. This is the maximum value of the response in time domain. This is the maximum value of response in frequency domain. As long as zeta value is less than 1 by root 2, MR will be greater than 1. When zeta value is 1 by root 2, MR becomes 1. When zeta value is greater than 1 by root 2, MR does not exist. Because omega R does not exist. If you observe, page number 71. Page number 71. Question number 11. देखो. What is the value of damping ratio when resonant peak is unity? When resonant peak unity, zeta value will be 1 by root. The answer is. 10th question dekho. Question number 10. M of j omega is given as 100 by 100 minus omega square. 10 root 2 j omega. We have to find its MP. MP means what will you find? E power minus g pi expression you will use or this expression you will use? MP dekhe, ek hi line mein nahi sochna. MP ke brackets mein kya diya, wo bhi padhna. Kya diya? Peak magnitude ka matlab MR hai wo. MR ko that fellow is representing it as MP. You understand? तो इसको पहले टाइम कांस्टेंट फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट करो एंड यू सी दिस इज एस सी एट एस सी इक्वल टू जे ओमेगा ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन है ये सो द टाइम कांस्टेंट कन्वर्शन विल बिकम 1 बाय ओमेगा स्क्वायर बाय 100 10 रूट 2 जे ओमेगा बाय 100 दिस इज 1 बाय ओमेगा बाय 10 होल स्क्वायर रूट 2 ओमेगा बाय 10 Compare this with the standard sinusoidal transfer function of second order system. J into 2 zeta omega by omega n. So 2 zeta omega by omega n value is root 2 omega by 10. Omega n value is 10. Omega will get cancelled. Zeta value is 1 by root 2. अगर जीटा वैल्यू 1 बाय रूट 2 है तो ये जो एमआर है एमआर को दैट फेलो इज राइटिंग इट एज एमपी क्या है इसका वैल्यू 1 है ये है आंसर over which the magnitude has a value of it is the range of frequencies over which the magnitude has a value of 1 by root 2 it is the range of frequencies over which the magnitude has a value of 1 by root 2 It indicates speed of response of the system. It indicates speed of response of the system. Wider bandwidth implies faster response. Wider bandwidth implies faster response. You see, bandwidth is frequency. Frequency f is 1 by t. The frequency is more. It means time period is less. If time period is less, it means the response is fast. Speed of response of a system is defined in terms of rise time. Speed of response is defined in terms of rise time. Frequency f is equal to 1 by t relation is bandwidth is proportional to 1 by tr. What is this TR? Where TR is rise time. So if rise time is more, it means bandwidth is less. If rise time is less, it means bandwidth is more. This is the relation between rise time and bandwidth. नेक्स्ट कट ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी, कट ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी it is defined as, it is defined as the frequency at which the magnitude has a value of 1/√2. It is defined as the frequency at which the magnitude has a value of 1/√2. It indicates the ability of the system. Indicates the ability of the system to distinguish signal from noise. To distinguish signal from noise. Sharp cutoff characteristics. Sharp cutoff characteristics is an indication of less bandwidth. Sharp cutoff characteristics is an indication of less bandwidth. So you see, the definition of bandwidth and cutoff frequency is same. It is the frequency at which the magnitude has a value of 1/√2. The expression also will remain same. So in the range of frequencies, that frequency beyond which only noise will be amplified, the noise will be available. That frequency cutoff, that frequency is called as cutoff frequency. So the magnitude of the second order system, magnitude of f of j omega is 1/√2 1 minus u square whole square 2 zeta u whole square, where what is u? Omega by omega. At omega equal to omega c equal to cutoff frequency, u is equal to uc omega c by omega. So this magnitude at omega c value become uc square 2 zeta uc whole square, and this magnitude is having a value of 1/√2 1 minus uc square whole square 2 zeta uc whole square is equal to 2 1 plus uc 4 minus 2 uc square 4 zeta square uc square minus 2 equal to 0. Uc 4 4 zeta square minus 2 minus 1 equal to 0. The expression of uc is obtained by finding the roots of this polynomial minus b plus or minus root of b square 4ac divided by 2a. So this is 1 minus 2 zeta square plus or minus of 16 zeta 4 plus 8 by 2. 1 minus 2 zeta square 4 zeta 4 4 zeta square plus 2. Frequency cannot be negative. So discard the negative root and take only the positive root. So you have uc square is equal to root of 4 zeta 4, 4 zeta square plus 2. Uc will become whole root of this. 1 minus 2 zeta square, 4 zeta 4, 4 zeta square plus 2. Omega c or bandwidth will be omega n into root of 4 zeta 4 minus 4 zeta square plus 2. This is the expression to calculate the second order system's bandwidth or cutoff frequency value. Now this expression is linearly approximated to the linear approximation is omega c or bandwidth. This entire thing is approximated to minus 1.19 zeta plus 1.85. This is called as the linear approximation of bandwidth relation, which means whatever value you calculate using this expression for values of zeta and omega n will be approximately equal to this value with plus or minus of 1 or 2 tolerance, but it will be close to this value. So this expression will be helpful in calculating bandwidth of a second order system when calculators are not allowed. Frequency response analysis of dead time or transportation lag. Frequency response analysis of dead time or transportation lag. So if you remember, time domain methods, dead time was approximated as 1 minus Ts. In frequency domain, you cannot take 1 minus Ts. So if you are drawing a Bode plot or polar plot or Nyquist plot, if e power minus s factors are there, e power minus Ts factors are there, you cannot take 1 minus Ts and solve in frequency domain methods. So let us see what is the approximation of this dead time in frequency domain. What is the analysis of this dead time in frequency domain? The dead time element is represented as f of s equal to y of s by x of s equal to e power. In frequency response, put s equal to j omega e power minus j omega t. Now this is cos omega t minus j sin omega t. Magnitude of f of j omega will become root of real part square plus imaginary part square. Negative sign inside square makes no sense. Sin square theta plus cos square theta value will be 1. So this magnitude, this dead time will have a magnitude of 1. phase angle is defined as tan inverse of imaginary by real. So this will become tan inverse of minus tan omega t. Will become minus omega t. This value is in radians. So this dead time e power minus j omega t is having a magnitude of 1 and is having an angle of minus omega t radians. This is the analysis, frequency response analysis of dead time. So pi radians is 180 degrees. Minus omega t is how much? Minus omega t by pi into 180 will become minus 57.3 omega t degrees. In degrees, this is the angle. So this dead time will have a magnitude of 1, and in degrees, it contributes an angle of 57.3 omega t. This is the frequency response analysis to be considered for this dead time element. You should not take 1 minus Ts in frequency response methods. Subheading, stability from frequency response plots. Stability from frequency response plots. You see here, stability of a system depends on the roots of the characteristic equation 1 plus GSHS equal to 0. So in frequency response also, we express the characteristic equation as G of S H of S equal to minus 1. Because it is frequency domain methods, we put S equal to J omega. So G of J omega, H of J omega is minus 1 plus J 0. This point, we call it as critical point in frequency response. We are now defining stability criteria with this, for this representation of characteristic equation, which is G of S, H of S equal to minus 1. So similar to root locus, if you want to draw a polar plot, Bode plot or Nyquist plot, you need not consider a closed loop transfer function. You can draw the frequency response plot directly for open loop transfer function. Whatever criteria we are going to observe this, whatever criteria we are going to define, observe this criteria from the plot which you have drawn for the open loop transfer function. Whatever stability analysis you deduce out of it, it relates to the stability of closed loop system only. Similar to root locus. To draw root locus, you require what transfer function? What is the final shape? Closed loop system, and analysis is for closed loop poles. You are defining stability, relative stability of the closed loop system there. Similarly, here also, because the criteria is defined for GSH is equal to minus 1, a polar Nyquist or a Bode plot you can draw directly for open loop transfer function. And whatever stability analysis that you get out of it by observing this criteria, the stability relates to closed loop system only. You understand? We define four important terms. The first one is called as gain, crossover, frequency, abbreviated as omega GC. It is defined as the frequency at which the magnitude of this open loop transfer function at this frequency should become 1 or 0 dB. Why at this specific frequency the magnitude value should be 1? Why only 1? Because G of S, H of S is minus 1. Magnitude of G of S, H of S is 1. That's why at this specific frequency the magnitude should become 1. The second one we define is a phase crossover frequency, abbreviated as omega PC. It is defined as the frequency at which the phase angle of this open loop transfer function should become plus or minus of 180. Why at this specific frequency the angle should be 180? Why not 90 or any other angle? Because the angle of minus 1 is 180. That's why at this specific frequency the angle should become 180. Analysis, whatever analysis we are doing is applicable for LTI systems. And LTI transfer functions should be minimum phase functions. Minimum phase functions, phase angle will always be minus of P minus Z into 90. So overall phase angle jo hai, minus of P minus Z into 90 hai. Abhi ye minus of P minus Z into 90 kya negative value hai ya positive value hai? Minus of P minus Z into 90 is the phase characteristics of the minimum phase system. So is this angle, overall angle, which is minus of P minus Z into 90, is it negative hai or positive? This means that plus 180 aane ka chance hi nahi. Therefore we say the angle should be minus 180. The third one is called as gain margin. Gain margin is abbreviated as GM. Gain margin ka matlab, it is the allowable gain. Allowable gain means if you add this much amount of gain to a system, the system tends to go to the verge of instability. That allowable gain is called as gain margin. The procedure for finding gain margin is find what is the magnitude at phase crossover frequency. Let this magnitude be x. Gain margin is defined as 1 by x. Gain margin in decibels is 20 log of 1 by x. This is the procedure. The fourth one is called as phase margin. It is the allowable phase lag. That means if you add this much amount of phase lag to a system, the system tends to become unstable. It goes to the verge of instability. The procedure for finding this phase margin value is, find out what is the phase angle of open loop transfer function at gain crossover frequency. Let this phase angle value be phi. Phase margin of a system is defined as 180 plus phi. So why gain margin is calculated at phase crossover frequency and why we take it as 1 by x, why phase margin is called phase lag, and why we calculate at gain crossover frequency and why do we take 180 plus phi, all these things I will show from the plot. It becomes easy to understand. For a system to be stable, the condition is this gain margin and phase margin should be positive. The system will be unstable if this gain margin and phase margin values are negative. The system is said to be marginally stable if this gain margin and phase margin values become zero. So whether it is a polar plot or whether it is a Bode plot or any frequency response plot, if you want to comment on stability, you have to find the values of GM and both should be positive values. Then only the system is said to be stable. Omega GC and omega PC will be, GM and PM will be positive when omega GC is less than omega PC. GM and PM are negative because this omega GC becomes greater than omega PC. These are equal because these two frequency values will become, this will be zero when these two frequency values become zero. Calculate this omega GC, omega PC, to calculate this GM and PM, what transfer function you are using, open loop or closed loop? But yeah, jo bhi GM, PM hum calculate kar rahe hain, jo stability ma pata karne ke liye, kya ye open loop system ke liye hai? This for closed loop system. Because the criteria is defined for GSH is equal to minus 1, which means analysis will be for closed loop system only. But to calculate this GM and PM, we are using only open loop transfer function. Next subheading, GM and PM for second order system. GM and PM for second order system. You see, this is the transfer function of a second order system. C of S by R of S equal to omega n square by 2 zeta omega ns plus omega n square. But to calculate GM and PM, we don't require a closed loop transfer function characteristic. We require open loop function. What is the open loop transfer function of the second order system? It is omega n square by square plus 2 zeta omega ns, or this is omega n square by s into s plus 2 zeta omega n. Because it is frequency response analysis, put s equal to j omega, g of j omega will become omega n square by j omega plus 2 zeta omega n. This is nothing but omega n square plus j0, 0 plus j omega, जे ओमेगा प्लस टू जीटा ओमेगा एन. फाइंड व्हाट इज द मैग्नीट्यूड. मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ जी ऑफ जे ओमेगा विल बिकम ओमेगा एन स्क्वायर बाय ओमेगा रूट ऑफ ओमेगा स्क्वायर प्लस फोर जीटा स्क्वायर ओमेगा एन स्क्वायर. फाइंड द फेज एंगल. दिस इज जीरो, दिस इज 90, एंड दिस इज tan inverse of imaginary by real. So the total phase angle will become minus 90 minus tan inverse of omega by 2 zeta omega n. This is the magnitude and this is the phase angle. Are these two transfer functions same or are these two transfer functions different? Same. Suppose if I take this representation of second order system transfer function, if I take this representation, g of j omega will become omega n square by minus omega square plus 2 zeta omega n into j omega. I am putting s equal to j omega in this representation now. This will become what? Omega n square plus j0 minus omega square plus j into 2 zeta omega omega n. J into 2 zeta omega omega n. If you observe, this point is lying in which quadrant? Second quadrant. What will be the angle of this point? The angle of this point will be 180 minus tan inverse of imaginary by real. Omega square and omega will get cancelled. What is the angle now? Minus 180 plus tan inverse of 2 zeta omega n by omega. Are these two angles same or are they different? The two transfer functions are same. We have to find gain crossover frequency and phase crossover frequency. What is phase crossover frequency? It is defined as the frequency at which this angle or this angle should become minus 180. If you observe, only when omega is infinity, tan inverse infinity becomes 90. Minus 90, minus 90, angle becomes minus 180. Only when omega is infinity, anything by infinity will become, angle is minus 180. So the phase crossover frequency of a second order system is at omega equal to omega pc equal to infinity. This phase angle of a second order system will become minus 180. So the phase crossover frequency of a second order system is infinity. This phase crossover frequency, when you substitute in the magnitude of this at phase crossover frequency of infinity will give you the value of x. So in this magnitude, put omega equal to infinity. Anything by infinity is how much? Zero. So x value will become zero. What is the definition of gain margin? 1 by x. How much? 1 by 0 is infinity. So for a second order system, phase crossover frequency will be infinity. Gain margin also will be infinity. What is gain crossover frequency? It is the frequency at which this magnitude value should become 1. If I assume this omega to be omega gc, then this magnitude should have a value of 1. So at omega equal to omega gc, this magnitude value omega n square by omega root of omega square 4 zeta square omega n square value should be 1. ओमेगा एम फोर इज इक्वल टू ओमेगा स्क्वायर प्लस फोर जीटा स्क्वायर ओमेगा एम स्क्वायर, ओमेगा स्क्वायर फोर जीटा स्क्वायर ओमेगा एम स्क्वायर माइनस ओमेगा एम फोर इक्वल टू जीरो. The expression for omega is obtained by finding the roots of this polynomial. What are the roots of this polynomial? Minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. So the roots are minus zeta square omega n square plus or minus of, take out 4 omega n 4 common, this will become omega n square root of 4 zeta 4 plus 1. Yahan pe frequency cannot be negative, so discard the negative root and take only the positive root. Omega square will be equal to minus zeta square omega n square root of 4 zeta 4 plus 1. Therefore, this is 2 zeta square. Okay. So, omega equal to omega, don't feel bad, is equal to omega n root of minus 2 zeta square plus root of 4 zeta 4 plus 1. This is the expression to calculate the gain crossover frequency in terms of zeta and omega n values. Now this gain crossover frequency value, when you substitute in this angle, or when you substitute in this angle, you will get the value of 5. So, phase angle of g of j omega at omega equal to omega gc will give you the value of 5. Minus 90 minus tan inverse of, substitute in place of this omega this expression. This will become omega n under root of minus 2 zeta square under root of 4 zeta 4 plus 1 divided by 2 zeta omega n. Omega n, omega n will get cancelled. Phase margin is defined as what? 180 degrees plus 5. 180 minus 90. Kitna? 90. So the expression of phase margin is 90 minus tan inverse of under root of minus 2 zeta square root of 4 zeta 4 plus 1 by 2 zeta. This is the expression to calculate phase margin. If you observe, phase margin of a second ordered system depends only on the value of zeta. So for a second ordered system, phase margin ka significance kya hai? Damping. Phase margin ka significance indicates, because phase margin is the function of only zeta. You take the second angle now, this angle. Phase angle of g of j omega at omega equal to omega gc will be 5. Minus 180 plus tan inverse of 2 zeta omega n by omega n into root of 4 zeta 4 plus 1. Omega n will get cancelled. Phase margin is defined as 180 degrees plus 5. 180 minus 180 will become 0. So the phase margin is tan inverse of 2 zeta by root of minus 2 zeta square root of 4 zeta 4 plus 1. This is another alternate expression to calculate phase margin of a second order system. Suppose in the exam a question is asked like this. A certain second order system has a damping ratio of 0.5. Calculate its phase margin. No transfer function, nothing is given. Then you can use either this expression or this expression. You can get the value of phase margin just from the information of damping ratio for a second order system. Whatever value you get out of this expression or this expression, this value is linearly approximated to phase margin is linearly approximated to 100 times of zeta. This is the linear approximation of phase margin and damping ratio relation. Iska matlab agar zeta value 0.5 hai to phase margin kitna hai? 50. Use this expression or this expression, you will be getting an answer as 49 point something, 50 point something. Maximum tolerance is 5 degrees, but you will be getting an answer within plus or minus of 1 or 2 degrees only. Samajh mein aaya? Ek hi taraf sochta kya rahe hain? Pura class samajh mein aaya? Tu aaya tha आंखें फाड़ फाड़ के देख रहा है क्या है?
मराठी है
तो जस्ट लुक एट दिस क्वेश्चन आफ्टरवर्ड्स यू राइट ये क्वेश्चन एक बार देखो page number 72. The phase margin and damping ratio, वो bracket में 2 zeta नहीं है, वो zeta 2 print mistake है, cut करो उसको. Phase margin and damping ratio zeta are related by. What is the answer? क्या है आंसर? हाँ, ये इसका आंसर. अंडरस्टैंड? सो द नेक्स्ट क्लास विल बी आफ्टर अ शॉर्ट ब्रेक ऑफ 15 मिनट्स. पोलर प्लॉट्स. द नेक्स्ट सब हेडिंग इज पोलर प्लॉट्स. It is a plot of absolute values of magnitude. It is a plot of absolute values of magnitude and phase angle in degrees and phase angle in degrees of open loop transfer function g of j omega h of j omega. Open loop transfer function g of j omega h of j omega versus omega drawn on polar coordinates. Now listen here. Explain if you want to mark the polar coordinates on an S-plane, all positive angles are taken in anti-clockwise direction and all negative angles are taken in clockwise direction. Magnitudes are calibrated with respect to x-axis. A negative hai, a positive hai, but absolute value will always be positive. This angle will be plus 90, this angle will be plus 180, this angle will be plus 270, plus 360 or 0. This angle will be minus 90, minus 180, minus 270, minus 360 or 0. And when you are calibrating the magnitudes, magnitudes are calibrated with respect to x-axis. For example, suppose we want to mark 5 angle minus 145 degrees on an S-plane, because you will be getting polar coordinate points like this, magnitude angle, for different values of omega. The procedure for marking this point on an S-plane, you have to draw this angle, phasor of this angle, whatever is given, because it is negative. You have to draw it in clockwise direction. So this is minus 145 degree angle. Draw a circle whose radius is 5. This is the circle. The circle will be cutting minus 5 and plus 5. Though this side is negative, this side is positive, absolute values are all positive ones. Wherever this circle cuts this line, this point is taken as 5 angle of minus 145 degrees. This is the procedure of actually marking the polar coordinate points. But however, accurate polar plot we can never draw. It is not possible. In polar plot, what we require is only shape of the plot. And from that shape of the plot, how to find gain margin and phase. This is important. Another important thing that we have to know is the travel of angle. Suppose you want to travel from plus 180 to minus 180, minus 180 to plus 180, plus 90 to minus 90, like that. Suppose I want to travel from plus 90 to minus 90. From whichever angle you want to travel, first you go to that angle. Suppose I want to travel from plus 90 to plus minus 90, a zero here. Zero, if I go in this direction anti-clockwise, I am going to plus 90. After going there, take the same path back, plus 90 to 0, 0 to minus 90, which means when I start in first quadrant and end in fourth quadrant, we are travelling from plus pi by 2 to minus pi by 2. If you reverse the direction, minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Suppose I want to travel from 180 to 180. Plus 180 to minus 180 or minus 180 to plus 180. First you go to plus 180, a 0, plus 90, plus 180. Now you take the same path back, plus 180 to 0, minus 90, minus 180. You are starting from second quadrant, passing through first, fourth, third, ending in third quadrant. So, if you travel in this direction like this, you are starting from plus pi, 0, minus pi by 2 and minus pi. If you reverse this direction, minus pi to plus pi. Suppose I want to travel from 270 to 270. 0, plus 90, plus 180, plus 270. You start from plus 270. Plus 270 to 0, minus 90, minus 180, minus 270. A plus 3 pi by 2 to 0, minus pi by 2, minus pi, and minus 3 pi by 2. If you reverse the direction of the spiral, you will be travelling from minus 3 pi by 2 to plus 3 pi by 2. You understand? Suppose I want to travel from plus 90 to plus 270. Plus 90 to plus 270. Starting in which quadrant, ending in which quadrant? Plus 90 to plus 270. Zero, a plus 90. Second quadrant you are starting. Plus 90 to plus 180. Plus 180 to plus 270. Second to third. अगर वही प्लस 270 टू प्लस 90 है तो पहले प्लस 270 पे आना, देन यू टेक द सेम पाथ बैक, थर्ड टू सेकंड, जीरो टू माइनस 270 है, जीरो टू माइनस 270, हाँ, स्टार्टिंग एंड एंडिंग वेयर, जीरो टू माइनस 270 बोले तो ये जीरो, फोर्थ से शुरू माइनस 90, माइनस 180, एंडिंग इन सेकंड. अगर वही माइनस 270 टू जीरो है तो पहले यू हैव टू गो टू माइनस 270 एंड देन यू शुड टेक द सेम पाथ बैक. ऐसा नहीं आना, समझ में आया? नो शॉर्टकट्स. इज दिस क्लियर? नाउ व्हाई एन एक्यूरेट पोलर प्लॉट वी कैन नेवर प्लॉट. If you observe, say for example, this is the open loop transfer function given, 1 by s plus 1. To draw a polar plot, Nyquist plot or any plot, convert this in time constant form. Always remember, in frequency response, it is better to take transfer functions in time constant, because angle, taking angles become easy. So 1 plus s, put s equal to j omega, 1 plus j omega. Find what is the magnitude. 1 by root of 1 plus omega square and find what is the angle. Minus tan inverse of omega. So we are varying omega, observing how the magnitudes and angles are changing. Starting omega 0. Ending omega infinity. Put omega 0, the magnitude is 1, angle is 0. Magnitude is 0, angle is minus 90. So if you look at the angles 0 to minus 90, you have to go from 0 to minus 90. 0 to minus 90, bole to, which quadrant? 0 to minus 90. You are starting in 4th, ending in 4th only. You understand? And magnitudes, if you observe, are between 1 and 0. Suppose if I want to draw an accurate polar plot, accurately you have to calibrate the x-axis. A 0, a 1, minus 1, 2, minus 2. Accurately you have to calibrate. Magnitudes, if you observe, are between 1 and 0. And angles are between 0 and minus 90. So these are the different angles you will be getting for different values of omega, like this. Starting omega 0, ending omega infinity. Or magnitudes jo hai, ye 1 or 0 ke beech mein hai. So you will be drawing circles of these different magnitudes and these circles will be getting these angle lines. So agar accurate calibrate karenge, to polar plot sirf yehi region mein hoga. You understand? So accuracy of the plot is not important in polar. What is important? Shape. So I am taking 1 here. So when omega is 0, this is the circle I have drawn whose magnitude is 1. It is cutting angle here. At the same equidistant point, you have minus 1 also. Now if you observe, the magnitudes are between this 1 and 0. So you will be drawing different circles of different magnitudes. These circles will be cutting these angle lines. Wherever they cut these angle lines, those points you have to mark and join them. Whatever shape you get, that shape we call it as polar plot. So for this problem, this is the shape of the plot we will be getting. This is starting omega 0, ending omega infinity. You understand? So shape of the plot only is important for us, but not the accuracy of the plot. Now this is what type and what ordered system? Type 0, when omega is 0, the angle will always be 0. It starts from 0 degrees. If there is an S term here, it becomes type 1. When omega 0, starting angle will be minus 90. So type 1 will start from minus 90. Type 2 will start from minus 180. Type 3 will start from minus 270. Type 4, minus 360. Type of the system will determine where the polar plot will start. So we say a type 0 plot starts from here because the angle is 0. A type 1 plot starts here because the angle is minus 90. A type 2 plot starts from here because the angle is minus 180. Type 3 will start here because the angle is minus 270. And this is what order system? First order. First order is ending in fourth quadrant at origin. First order is ending in fourth quadrant at origin, which means second order will end in third quadrant. Third order will end in second quadrant, and fourth order will end in first quadrant. Fifth order, sixth order, that will continue. So type of the system will determine the starting of the polar plot, and order of the system will determine ending of the polar plot. So with respect to this type and order, there are some general shapes. If you remember these general shapes, it is more than sufficient.